Good morning. You're on FloridaDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. This morning, my guest is Mark Clayton, the president of Phoenix Flooring. Mark, how you doing?
I'm good, Kemp. How are you doing this morning?
I'm good. I wanted to catch up on your plan moving forward with the news of the Stainmaster being part now of Lowe's. Before we get to that, let me cover a couple of things real quick. Most people know Phoenix is owned by Mannington now. And first thing I want to mention is our annual report just came out yesterday. It's available online and also be in the mailbox here in the next couple of days. But in the carpet section in our annual report, big news there, you're number five. So with what Mannington was doing on the commercial side with carpet already, and then what the addition of you on the residential side, that puts you in fifth place ahead of the Dixie Group by about $40 million. So that's pretty big news when you start looking at the relative size of the carpet producers. So congratulations on that.
Yeah, thank you. We obviously are excited to continue to grow our carpet share, and that's a great reflection of that, so thank you.
Another thing I want to point out, the CRI comes out with a report that talks about the business. You know, they compile data from all of the members and then publish a report stripping away all the identity. But that report says that in the first quarter on the residential side, sales from a dollar perspective were up almost 20%. And then up 10% from a unit perspective, and that tells us that people are buying more expensive carpet, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we've been seeing that trend occur over the past couple of years, but certainly the first quarter of this year, I think we were all pleasantly surprised at not only the growth in this soft surface category, but as you mentioned, particularly consumers are upgrading, upselling themselves with better-end products, selling more pattern. And we're pleased to see that happen. Obviously, it helps when we're all seeing higher ASPs.
Let's move to this Stainmaster news. The news came out a couple of weeks ago that brand name is now a Lowe's asset and all of the sub-brands as well, which include PepperTech. And so with a company like Phoenix, who, if you know the history of Phoenix, started out as LoopTech, started out kind of really focused in the home centers, you have a major chunk of business in the home centers as well as a nice piece of business with independent retail. I just recently saw you at the NFA show. So this is going to mean probably two things to you. It'll mean an uptick in business with your Lowe's business under that Stainmaster brand name, sourced with probably continuing to source fibers from Invista.
Well, as you mentioned, I mean, Lowe's is an important customer of ours, and certainly it's a great opportunity for them now that they've acquired this brand for themselves, and I'm sure they're going to leverage that to the fullest extent. So we're looking forward to opportunities there to enhance our position and grow business with Lowe's. But I think even within the independent retail channel, as some of the key retailers that you've even been interviewing lately have indicated, this actually frees them up to try some things and have a little more flexibility on the showroom floor. So I think in the long haul, this will be good for everyone concerned.
Yeah. As we look at Phoenix's business to the independent retailer, when it comes to Stainmaster, you were really not there in any white dyeable. You were just doing their solution dyed under the PepperTech brand name. Isn't that right?
Yeah, over the years, we have participated lightly in a couple of the white dye programs, but core focus has always been on the 997's PepperTech Solution Dye program. At this point, that's the only Stainmaster branded products that we support.
So with this brand name now being owned by a competitor to these independent retailers, what is your short-term plan to make sure those samples that are out there continue to use to sell to the consumer?
We want to minimize disruption to the independent retailers, and we want to support them to make sure that that happens. So we are putting the final touches on a new program that we'll be rolling out. Hopefully, we'll be able to communicate that broadly next week. But we will essentially continue to support the products that are in the retail environment today, labeled as PepperTech. We will be retrofitting those samples with a new branded program. We're essentially going to leverage the Forever banner that we have today and introduce a new collection under Forever Pet Plus. So we'll leverage the robust warranty platform that we already have today with Forever with added benefits to support the warranties for the pet lover. Again, we're going to continue to support those products. We hope customers, our retailers, will continue to drive those products, and we'll certainly support them with the warranty structure that they're accustomed to.
All right, so don't throw out the samples. We're going to help you relabel, move away from the brand. Still going to use on those current styles that are there. These samples are still good. The product is still beautifully styled. So,
right.
So you'll support that Pet Protect program with your Forever brand. And then long term, you've got this FAR operation, you know, your own yarn facility. And so what's your plan long term?
You know, like we talked about this at the NFA convention, we are just in the process of rolling out a new program called Forever, which leverages a new nylon program that we've created and we extrude in our FAR facilities in North Carolina, SureSoft SDN. SureSoft SDN is a solution dyed nylon 6 cationic nylon,
yeah.
So it's inherently very stain resistant. We're going to obviously continue to drive that brand, but we're going to leverage that to a greater extent with this Forever Pet Plus program with some enhanced warranties. We see a great opportunity for us to leverage our yarn assets in North Carolina and create additional utilization for us there.
Guys, as people know, there's a lot of Stainmaster flooring dealers that are going to be resetting their showroom because there's been these displays with Stainmaster written on them. And so you've got some offerings that you're going to be come forward with, and you'll be working to build some of your shelf space there with these new products, right, long term?
Oh, yeah. I think long term you'll see, obviously, we'll be trying to drive, I think, better value there for the consumer.
The good news, too, is that Invista wouldn't let you put the Microban on their yarn system, so you'll be able to put Microban on everything you have now, right?
Yeah, that's something we're really excited about. I mean, we have, as you know, an exclusive agreement with Microban to provide that technology on our carpet products, and we'll also be leveraging that on LVT products as well this summer. So we feel like this will give us an opportunity to further leverage the benefits of Microban through our pet program. So great differentiator for our company.
All right, Mark, thanks for spending time with us today and letting us know what's going on with Phoenix as it relates to all the current news. Again, been talking to Mark Clayton, the president of Phoenix Flooring, and you've been listening to Kempar and FloridaDaily.net.